Here we have another exciting video for all you homeowners out there. We're going to be talking about how to get the insurance company to pay for water damage in 2022. Things have changed a lot. Insurance companies are really giving a hard time to homeowners for any type of claim that you file. So we're going to talk about how we can help and what you can do to help get your claim paid. Now, it all starts with your initial phone call to the insurance company, believe it or not. This initial call is going to be something that can make or break your claim. Because what you say is going to carry that weight moving forward. That's what they're going to use to try, whatever your words are, to try and use against you. So the key to your claim will be more than likely, was your claim or is your claim a sudden leak, a pipe breaks, a pipe leaks, slab leak that may have happened out of blue, cast iron pipes, okay? Did it just happen? Water's all over your floor, water's in your cabinets, or is it a long-term leak? Long-term leak underneath your slab can be an example of a long-term leak you had no idea. Behind a bathroom wall, behind a kitchen cabinet, maybe you have a wall for your pipes. And then you notice one day that you open up underneath your sink in the cabinets to reach for your dishwashing liquid or dish detergent, and you see water all over the place in the back of your cabinets, right? So you tell the insurance company you didn't know you had the leak. That's going to be bad. So if you look at up here, depending on which type of leak you have will help determine the fate of your claim. More than likely, I would rather you have a sudden leak, but of course this isn't a perfect world. Sudden leaks are going to put you in a better position, right? Long-term leaks, I would probably advise before you even call the claimant, get somebody to help you with the claim. PA right here, meaning public adjuster. And the reason being is this. Here's why when you have a long-term leak, it's usually very important that you hire somebody on your behalf. Because in the policy, in every homeowner's policy, it states repeated or constant seepage or leakage is excluded. All right. They will put that in a denial letter to you. So if you're watching this video, thinking about putting a claim in and you think you've had a long-term leak or a leak that's been there for a while, call a public adjuster. A good public adjuster will know how to handle it. All right. Short-term leaks are not out of the clear because what's going to happen is more than likely, depending on how much of the damage, they may send a leak detection person. They may send an engineer. And even though it was a short-term leak, maybe a week before you notice it, if there's any type of mold, they're going to try and say that it was long-term. They're going to try and say that the pipe was wear and tear. Pipes were old. Pipes were maintained. Don't fall for that. So, again, in 2022, we're living in a totally different insurance claim world than what we were 10 years ago. You've got to be almost quick on the dial of calling somebody who can help you with your claims because of the way insurance companies are treating people these days. Step number three in this process, okay, the claim handling procedures. So when the claim adjuster calls and sets an appointment to come look at your place, there's no need to be there. You don't have to be there. Listen, a lot of us work during the day. Just have a friend, neighbor, relative, let them in. If questions start being asked and that person doesn't know Or is there just simply to let them in, even if it's your wife? Listen, a lot of times, I know I have a husband or wife where one puts in a claim and handles everything. The other person works and doesn't really know what's going on. So I tell them, if your husband works, see if he can be there and just tell him he has, the husband should say, I have no idea what's going on. My wife is handling everything, vice versa. Okay? The other key thing is, let them being the insurance company and their quote unquote field independent adjuster, do the estimate before you get one. Because if they're gonna write a lowball estimate, you're gonna know, and there's gonna be, we're gonna talk about this in the next slide, there's gonna be a few options you can take if they write this lowball estimate. This is why you want them to write the estimate first. So leading up to the inspection will be about the documentation, what your plumber writes, and please talk to your plumber. If you had a pipe break, a pipe that leaked and needs to be replaced, talk to your plumber and make sure he puts it in the report. So many times in the invoice, so many times I just have the plumber put service $250. Well, come on, put something in there. That will help your claim tremendously if the plumber can document it. And then obviously the other thing is having photos of the water, having photos of videos of the damage. Even if the plumber replaces a hose or a pipe, take pictures of that. Take a video of that. That's going to help your claim. Step five, the post inspection, meaning after the insurance adjuster has come out to your home. As I mentioned, if it's a lowball estimate, okay, you're gonna have two options that I would prefer you listen to me on. Number one, you could hire a public adjuster because you know you're gonna be in for a fight. Or number two, you could produce now at this point your estimate and ask for a re-inspection. Okay, I'm gonna talk about another point with this estimate in a second, but usually it's at this stage in the game where things are almost at the end of the road for you. But there are a couple more things that you can do. All right, so let's talk about step six. This will be your final attempt at trying to get something resolve with the insurance company with regards to your claim. So you can contact the manager. You can get a second estimate. Now, something about the estimate. When you get an estimate from a contractor, make sure they put in there adding on 20% for overhead and profit. 10% overhead, 10% profit, 20%. All right. If you have a lot of things that you have to move around, you get what's called content manipulation. So then ask them if you have asked them for a re-inspection, they refuse, make sure you get that in writing and put the reasons why. Very important. You can file for the state of Florida, which has a program for mediation to try and resolve it. Sometimes I do mediation, but only with claims that are worth less than $30,000. Okay, final point, make sure there's no appraisal clause where they can force you to an appraisal. You have to look at the policy. It's going to have two different things. One version of the verbiage is if we disagree on an amount, either you or we can ask for an appraisal. That's number one. The second type of policy and the verbiage that I sometimes see is if you and we disagree on the amount, either one can request an appraisal. However, both parties have to agree. All right. Okay, some key takeaways. Obviously, you want to have the documentation. You want to make sure your plumber, if you have to use a plumber, is documenting the invoice correctly. We also want to make sure that, this is a very important point, that most of your conversations are done by email. Do not write extended paragraph emails. Keep everything to a line or two. Unless there's some unusual reason that you have to write more than that, please keep your emails brief. You want them to put things in writing. You want them to commit as to why they're not covering things. If things are in an estimate and you're wondering why other things are not in the estimate, you question it and wait for their reply by email. If you call, I would rather you not call. I would rather 90% of your communications be in email and 10% by phone. If you do happen to call, I would want you to send a follow-up email on the conversation after that call. Everything's about documenting because so many claims are now moving into the lawsuit and litigation phase that you've got to be diligent with this. Obviously, all the other key takeaways or key points I have placed in this video are important, but this is also important. So hope you enjoyed watching this video. My name's Mike with the Claim Squad Public Adjusters. If you need to get a hold of me, here's the information on how you can do so. Following up, you can give me a call, you can text message me, you can send me an email. And also, like this video. If you don't like insurance companies like me, also subscribe to the channel. If you don't like insurance companies like me, you'll get more educational videos, more how-to tips, and just more things that will educate you on this claim process, because homeowners claims is far different than car accident or auto claims. Far different. Totally different animal. So even if you get one little thing out of one of my videos, I've done something positive for homeowners and for the community. Again, my name's Mike with the Claim Squad Public Adjusters. Thank you. Bad to the bone.